one. I love when autumn rolls around and all the winter squashes are available. Butternut squash is definitely one of my favorites. Recently, my husband and I were watching America's Test Kitchen, and they made a wonderful roasted butternut squash with a brown butter and hazelnuts. I could not find hazelnuts. I went to a couple of stores. I made this recipe last week, and I replaced it with pecans, and it was absolutely wonderful. I'm going to first start by peeling the butternut squash. After I peeled the squash, I sliced it in half, and now I'm going to scoop out the seeds. Use a spoon to pull out the stringy part and the seeds. I'm going to cut this part into half-inch moons. You can see that. And we'll just continue slicing this till it's all cut. This part will be solid. Place the squash into a large bowl. Pour on some melted butter. I'm going to add some salt and pepper. I'm going to toss that around and place it on a cookie sheet. I'll show you what it looks like. Place the pieces of squash single layered onto a cookie sheet. My oven has been preheated to 425. I'm going to place this on the bottom rack. I roasted the squash for 30 minutes. I rotated the pan and roasted it for an additional 6 to 8 minutes. Now I'm going to turn it over. You can see that it's getting caramelized on the bottom. After I turn these over, I'm going to place them back into the oven for about another 6 to 8 minutes until the second side is golden brown. The squash is nice and golden brown on the second side. I just make sure that I can insert a knife into it, and this is done. Place your pecans into a small skillet. I'm going to pan roast them on a medium-high heat. They'll take about 5 to 8 minutes. Just keep an eye on them so that they don't burn. Once you smell the aroma of the pecans, they are done. I gave the pecans a rough chop, place it back into a skillet, melt some butter. I'm going to let this cook for about 2 minutes on a medium-high heat until it gets a little bit golden brown. The butter's been browning for about 2 minutes. Now I'm going to add some cold water. It will sizzle. Let's see. And this will help to cool it down. Now I'm going to remove it from the heat. I let the butter cool for about a minute or two. Now I'm going to add some fresh lemon juice. Just stir that in. The squash is nice and crispy and golden brown. I placed it onto a serving platter. Now I'm just going to take some of the butter, well, actually all of it, pour that over. Smells wonderful. And I'm just going to sprinkle on some parsley for color. Guys, this is absolutely wonderful. It's a really delicious side dish. I hope you'll give this recipe a try. I'll leave a link down below to the recipe. Thanks for watching.